No, I think as a coach, particularly the way our season evolved, with so many things happening. Number one, the first game being postponed, and really eliminating our bye week, and going 12 straight weeks. It was handle that game Saturday, deal with it, win or lose, and then move on to the next game. And it probably wasn't until, I don't know, even when we were in New York sometime, flying around at these award shows, then I think that's when it kind of hits you that, hey, we've accomplished a lot as a team. I as a matter of fact, I haven't thought about it. I think, it's a great honor to be the SEC Coach of the Year. Number one, with the number of coaches that are involved in this league, many of which, there could have been argument for a lot of different guys, and I think it just, particularly from a coach's standpoint, who gets to vote, and from the AP standpoint, but I think as it relates to race, I think we're headed in a direction where, I hope one day that question's not asked, and that what I do, people see me as a coach and not a black coach. Coach Stoops, Bob has obviously had a huge influence on my coaching career. We've known each other for a long time. I think people might have been surprised. We were, we played in the same league. He was leaving when I was coming to Purdue, and Mike was playing. So was Jay Norville at Iowa, and I was playing at Purdue. And then as we moved on in coaching, we were actually recruiting South Florida together and recruiting a lot of the same players, whether I was at Minnesota or Purdue. He was at K-State. So, we were head-to-head all the time running around down there, and both of us had tough jobs trying to get guys to leave Miami and Fort Lauderdale to come to Manhattan, Kansas and Minneapolis, Minnesota, or West Lafayette. And, over the course of time, we've kept in touch. And then he hired me and spent 5 years at Oklahoma, which were, 5 great years. There's a long time in between those two losses. People act like those losses happened back to back. We lost the first game, and the first thing I did, number one, we never talked about what happened a year ago. I wasn't here. So whatever happened a year ago, win, lose, attitude, whatever that was, I wasn't here. We weren't playing the same league. We're a different team with different uniforms and different coaches. Well, a lot of that I'd like to take credit for as a play designer, but, we've got a quarterback who has the ability to as Coach Kingsbury, as Cliff used to say, would go rogue on us. So we can't take credit for everything. He's a very, very dynamic and very special player. And I think as the season went on, we understood him a little bit better. He understood what we were trying to do a little bit better with moving around and getting him moving. I think, we did design more quarterback run game in the plan, but that's all part of a lot of different things that he has taken advantage of, and it's we haven't had anybody, or I haven't had anybody, and we've been around a bunch of really good quarterbacks with his skill set, and it's a unique situation that we have. That we have a freshman who's won the highest award given in college football. It's never happened before. So the advice given is advice that has been based on, you know, it's a completely different situation than anybody has ever had. And, you know, usually it's you're looking at a player's either last game, the bowl game that he's playing in, or he may play one more year. That's it. This is a redshirt freshman. So, you know, the advice that you're giving is day-to-day advice. It's not career advice.